doing, man? What's happening?
Fine.
Good. Hi. Hi. Glad you could come, you know? Come on in and join us. Hey, did you just see me mail that letter? It was up in my hand, right? And I dropped it down into the mailbox. Up and down.
What are you telling them?
Well, I'm just talking about up and down. Come on over here, man.
No, okay.
Let's talk with Oscar. You know, I was telling them that things are up and things are down. You want to help me show them that, Oscar?
What, me?
Sure,
why not? You must be kidding.
Well, why not?
Grouch.
Well, Oscar.
Help people. You could just show them what you want to do by yourself. I'm not helping a bit.
Oh, he already helped us. He's up.
Yep.
No, I didn't help you.
Well, you're up. Thanks,
well,
Oscar.
Then I'm not going to stay here. I'm not going to help you in any way.
Oh, all right. And now he's down.
Help us again.
Yeah. Hey, Oscar. Thanks a lot.
Thanks for what?
Well, thanks for coming up. We're talking about up and down.
Well, I'm not going to stay up.
Oh, no? Okay. And now he's down.
Wait a minute.
And now he's up.
Oh, no. You are not going to get me into this.
Oh, no?
I'm not going to help you one bit, Gordon.
Oh, good.
That's final.
Oh, okay. And now he's down. Oh, he's come back up again.
No. Will you just... I'm not going to help you, okay?
You're not going to help?
No.
Okay, Oscar, don't help. All right,
all
good.
Right. All right.
Okay, fine.
I'm not going to help.
He's
okay.
Up. And now he's down again.
Wait a minute.
And now he's up again.
Wait.
Thanks,
I'm
going to
fix your goose.
Oh, what are you going to do, Oscar?
Yeah, I am just going to stay here, see?
Good, Oscar.
Yeah.
He's just going to stay here. He's up.
Up?
Yep.
That's right.
Oh, no. Listen, I'm leaving.
And now he's down.
Stop that, will you?
He's up again.
I'm going down.
And he's down again.
Wait a minute.
Hey, he's up again.
Hey, wait, I'm not playing this.
Oh, he's down again.
I'm not playing your game.
He's up
game.
Again. He's down. Ah, oh, he's up.
Ah.
Now he's down. Okay, thanks a lot, Oscar. Thanks.
Don't
oh,
pay me.
He's
I'll
up again.
Help anybody.
And now he's down.
Oh, well.
Oh, there he is again. Up. Down. Thanks, Oscar, very much. He showed us what up and down is.
Lefty, come here.
Yeah, boss?
Come here. All right. Now listen good and listen tight, because I'm going to give you this one time, and I don't want to have to tell you again. You understand?
Right.
Okay, now here it is. A, B, C, D. E, F, G, H. I, J, K, L. M N O P Q R S T U V W X Y Z. You got it?
Right, boss.
Okay, give it back to me.
Give it back to you?
That's what I said.
Right, boss, right. Let's see, there was a. A?
Yeah.
B, C, D, E, F, G.
Yeah, go on.
G, H, I, J, K, L, M.
M what?
N.
And don't you forget it.
Right. Then comes O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V.
Yeah.
And, let's see, there's, W, X, and, there's Y and Z. Z, yeah, that's it, boss.
Yeah. Hey, you did real good. I got a lollipop for you.
Oh, boy, for me, that's great. I love lollipops.
Hey, you really knew your alphabet good.
I try hard. Is that a raspberry or pineapple?
Oh, this is even better.
This is a letter G. G is a very useful letter. It's the first letter in the word. As I was saying, G is the first letter in the word. Now then, the letter G is the first letter in the word. The word. Giggle!
It's an otter!
She's a real Martian beauty, my number nine cutie. She has nine hairs on her head. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Tied up in ribbons of red. She has nine little eyes, all the same size, looking up, down, round, and straight ahead. She has nine little holes in her turned-up nose, and she snores when she goes to bed. She has nine arms, that's one of her charms, each just like the other. Some people say she looks like her dad. Some say she looks like a mother. She has one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine little toes on her foot. She doesn't go shopping because she doesn't like hopping. So usually she just stays put. Nine.
Greetings. I overheard someone talking about the difference between up and down. We machines are very good at describing the difference between up and down. I will now commence to function, demonstrating the difference between up and down. Watch my eyes, please. Now my eyes are looking up. Now my eyes are looking down. Now my eyes are looking up.
What are you looking up at, Sam?
Oh, I am not looking at anything, Oscar.
I am demonstrating
the difference between up and down.
Oh, no. You two, you know, you can demonstrate up and down somewhere away from my trash can.
Oh, good. Does that mean you'd like to help?
No, I won't help anybody with anything.
Fine. Oscar is now up in his can.
Didn't you hear me?
You.
I'm not up, but I'm leaving.
Now Oscar is down. Thank you.
Don't thank me because I'm not helping you.
Oscar is now up. Thank you.
No, I'm not.
Oscar is now down. Thank you.
Don't thank me. I'm not helping you.
Oscar is now up. Thank you. Oscar is now down. Thank you.
I don't believe this is happening to me.
Oscar is now up.
Wait a minute. I'm going to have to find something to throw at him.
Oscar is now down. Is now down. Is now down. Is now down. Thank you.
I was supposed to show you what the word up means. But, well, this is the word up, all right. But it's lying down now. I'll try to push them up. Ah, boy, this word up is heavy. Up now. Up. 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 Ah, there we are. I got them up. You see, up. U-P. Up.
E. E. L. Eel.
Jump, 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 jump. Jump, 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 jump. Jump, 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 jump.
E.
Down. Down, down. 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 Down, down. 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 Down.
G. G is for glue. Hello, young man.
Hi.
G is for glue and glove. G is for glue, glove, and gate. G is for glue, glove, gate, and guitar. G is for glue, glove, gate, guitar, and goose. G is for glue, glove, gate, guitar, goose, and gorilla. Oh, goody! G is for glue, glove, gate, guitar, goose, gorilla, and grandfather. G is for glue, glove, gate, guitar, goose, gorilla, grandfather, and grateful.
Greetings, frog lovers. It is me, Kermit the Frog, again, and today I'm going to talk to you about clues, okay? Clues. And this is kind of fun because it's sort of like being a detective. Now, let me show you what I mean. Over here, you will see that there's a little boy, and we're going to figure out what this little boy has been doing.
Hi, Frog.
Hello, dear. And we're going to figure it out by looking at the clues. Okay, now the first clue, in the little boy's hand, there is a hoe. See?
A hoe.
And another clue that in front of him is a watering can.
Mm-hmm.
That's a clue. And in his hand, there is a bunch of carrots. See that? That's a clue.
Mm-hmm.
And if you look closely at his overalls, you'll see that there is a little spot of dirt there.
Yes.
On the overalls. Okay? Now, looking at all of these clues, I have already figured out what this little boy has been doing.
Oh?
Okay? He has planted a vegetable garden. Okay? And he's been working very hard pulling weeds and watering, and today he has just harvested a big bunch of lovely carrots. Am I right?
Mm-hmm, that's right. I am a little boy who planted a vegetable garden, and I've worked very hard pulling weeds and watering, and today I just harvested a big bunch of lovely carrots.
Oh, I bet you didn't know I was a genius, did you?
No.
Yes, sir, figuring out clues is one of the things which us frogs do best. Let us take a look at another case. Here's another set of clues here. And let us figure out what this man has been doing.
Howdy, Bob.
Howdy yourself. Now, first clue is in his hand there is a hammer.
Yeah, my hammer.
Right, that's a clue. And in front of him, you'll notice that there is a saw and some pieces of wood.
Yeah.
And there's an empty paint can. That's a clue.
Yeah.
And there is a brand new birdhouse.
Yeah.
Okay, now judging from all of these clues, can we tell what this man has been doing? Yes, we can, and I will tell you. This man has taken those pieces of wood, and he has sawed them up with the saw, you see, and then he's nailed them together with the hammer, he painted them, and he has built a brand new birdhouse, right?
Yeah. I sawed up the wood, nailed the pieces together, painted them, and made this birdhouse.
Oh, well, isn't that marvelous? Oh, the wonders of me. I tell you, figuring out clues is really great fun. Let's try one last time. Now, here, there is a monster. Now, the clues here are that in the monster's hand, there is an umbrella.
Right.
And in front of the monster, there is a suitcase.
Right.
Now, judging from these clues, I can tell you that it is raining outside. And because the monster has a suitcase, we can tell that he's going on a trip. Right?
Wrong.
Wrong?
Wrong. Uh-uh. See, it's not raining outside, first of all.
Well, why do you have an umbrella if it's not to protect you from the rain?
Well, I'll tell you. See, this umbrella is not for protection. It's for lunch.
Well, then what's in the suitcase, then?
Ketchup.
Ketchup?
Yeah, who'd eat an umbrella without ketchup? Yuck! I'll just dip in for a little ketchup there.
It's got a whole
slap
suitcase
it on the umbrella.
Full of ketchup.
Here we go. Crunch.
I think that ends my discussion on clues.
Care for a bite?
No, thank you. I've eaten.
Hey, you know something? I'd like to play a game with you. Would you like to play a game with me?
Yeah. Yeah,
okay. Why not everybody take one of these trucks, all right? And you take one, you take one, and you, Sarah, and come over here and let's put them up on the board. Okay? That's right. Sarah, let Sarah get in so she can put her truck up on the board. Very good. Now, let me tell you something about this game. Two of these trucks are exactly the same. Got that? And two of them are different. Now, can you pick out two trucks that are exactly the same?
I know one.
Show me.
That one.
This one? Well, I don't know. Let's look around. This one and what else? This one and which one?
And this one.
Well, this one has everything. This one and this one are exactly the same?
Yeah. And this one don't have anything.
Okay, well, wait a minute. Tell me why it's different. Why are these different? Why are these two different?
Because it doesn't have any wheels.
Doesn't have any wheels, that's
it
right.
It doesn't have any doors.
And this one doesn't have any door, that's
and
right.
And no windows.
And no windows? Right on, man.
Okay,
draw
around a half a circle.
No, more.
Around that right there.
No.
Bring it up a little bit.
The bottom one a little bit further.
Oh, stop.
Now make a line across it.
No.
Across
right,
the line that you just...
No, right where the... Right where you ended at. Make a line across.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
What is it?
A G.
The letter G.
Step right up, step right up, lovely ladies and fine gentlemen, step right up and let Dandy David add a little something to your life. Tell you what I'm gonna do first off. I'm gonna put right up here, right there, a flower pot. Do you understand? I'm gonna put a flower pot up there. How about that? One flower pot. See that? One flower pot. Now, just to make things a little interesting, I'm going to add another flower pot. You understand? I'm going to put another flower pot up there. How about that? That's two flower pots. Thank you very much. I heard that. Two flower pots. Okay, tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to add a little spice of life. A little spice of life. I'm going to put another flower pot. Are you ready? Yes, you are. Two flower pots plus one flower pot is... Three flower pots. Hot dog. All right. Now, tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to add a flower. Yes, indeedy. I said a flower. There you go, flower. Look at that flower. Ain't that a flower? Okay, one flower. I told you I was going to add one flower. Now, tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to add another flower. It's not easy, but I'm going to do it. Dandy David does it again. You understand what I said? I said Dandy David does it again. One flower plus one flower is two flowers. How about that? You understand what I'm talking about? Okay, now, just watch this. What I'm going to do this time is I'm going to add another flower. You understand what I said? I said I'm going to add another flower. Yes, indeedy, David. Did you hear what I said? I said, yes, indeedy, David. David did it again. You have two flowers plus one flower is
3 flowers, that's right. Can't fool me. 3 flowers, okay. All right. Wait a minute. We got flower pots and we got soil. Flowers. What else makes flowers grow? Oh, yeah, water. Hey, tell me something. Anybody know where I can get some water? Huh?
Hello there. I'm a goat. Goat begins with the letter G.
Uh-oh.
This is the letter G. G has a ga sound, as in gopher or gorilla. I wanted to show you something that begins with the letter G, but I couldn't find a single thing. Wait, there is something. Right here. Grass.
The letter G. Yeah, my name begins with the letter G, and it makes that sound. George.
But my name begins with G, too, but it sounds like this. Grover. G. Grover.
No. G. George.
G. Garden.
No. G. Giant.
G. Gallop.
G. Giraffe.
No, I think this is right, Georgie. G. Golden.
And G. Gentle. Hey, Grover.
What, Georgie?
There are 2 G sounds.
I must agree. There is G, good guy.
And G, genius.
One sound for you and one sound for me. G, Grover.
G. George. G. Grover.
G. George. G. George.
G.
G. Gorilla. Gorilla.
Oh, hi, Big Bird. How are you?
Oh, hi, Bob.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm a carpenter type person
today.
No
kidding, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing here?
Well, this whole wall, all the old doors that we built here to make the wall of the playground,
yep.
They're all coming loose.
Right.
So I got a big bucket of nails from Mr. Stooper.
Hooper.
Mr. Hooper.
Right.
And it's full of nails. And I'm going to use this ladder so I can climb up to the top and put nails all the way along it so those boards won't fall off.
Hey, that's a terrific idea, Big Bird, but you know one thing? I don't think you should put your ladder here.
It's
not a good place, you know?
Yeah, I know, but no, I can't reach the top if I don't put
it
right
but
here.
You see, somebody might open the door and knock your nails off your ladder.
Oh, no, Bob, I already thought of that.
You did?
Yes.
So what are you going to do about it?
That's why I have a sign, see?
Oh, you made a sign?
Mm-hmm.
Turn it over so I can read it. It's upside down, Big Bird.
Oh, I thought the letters looked funny.
Yeah, I see. It says
do not open. And see, I'm just going to put it right on the door. Here, see?
Oh, well, that's not what I was thinking of, Big Bird.
There, now, people can all see it, and they won't open the door now, Bob.
No, but Big Bird, see, that's going to work now if somebody comes down the street from this way or this way. They'll see your sign, right, Big Bird? And they won't open the door.
No, they won't open the door.
Right, Big Bird. So far, good. But Big Bird, have you thought of this? What happens if somebody comes through the door from the other side?
Well, then it would spill.
Right.
I'd like to talk to you about the word up. U-P. Up. All right. Up is the way this arrow is pointing. Right up into the air. Now let me see. What else can I tell you about up? Well, if you wanted to go away up high, there are several ways you could do it. For instance, you could, can't seem to think of anything. There must be some way to go up. Well, if you wanted to go way high up in the sky, you could. I just don't know what you'd do if you wanted to go way high up in the sky. There must be some way to go way high up in the sky. I hear people talking about it all the time. It's beginning to rain. Rain does not go up. Rain comes down. Maybe I'd better talk about down. Yes, that's what I'll do. Now, most things that go up come down. I hope you've learned something from my little talk. Who put those things in the middle of the sidewalk? Don't they know that's dangerous? Of all the times I've been wondering about...
had a party when he was 9, which isn't bad. In fact, it's fine, except he asked 9 groovy swine to come for birthday cake and wine at 9:10, which isn't bad. In fact, it's fine, except his mom, sweet Adeline, who left the house at 9:01 to go to work at Smith and Klein, just hated swine to drink her wine, even on a day so fine as Bumble's birthday number 9. So, he simply didn't tell her. At 9:09, the piggy swine broke down the door and guzzled wine and hogged 9 cakes and oinked 9 grunts and pulled 9 kinds of dirty stunts. The house looked like a stinking sty. And Bumble Artie had to cry when all 9 swine squealed,
"Cheers, cheers, cheers! May Bumble live 900 years!"
Which isn't bad. In fact, it's fine. Except, just then, sweet Adeline, who finished work at 9:30 and hurried home so she could dine with Bumble on his birthday 9, and found instead 9 swilling swine, began to shriek and shake and whine.
"I'll give you pigs till 9 to split. Get lost, vamoose, just scram, or else I'll slice you into ham."
Nine times the door slammed. Then again. How odd, thought Adeline, that's 10. And then a voice cried, meek and humble,
"Please let me in. It's your boy Bumble."
So Adeline, that mom divine, took in her Bumble Valentine and kissed him 9 times over 9. Which isn't bad. In fact, it's fine.
Listen, I got a song I want you to help me with, all right?
Yeah,
let's sing it together. I'll tell you, it's a song about when your mother goes to the grocery store and she buys the groceries, right?
Yep. Right.
So what I want you to do is I want you to think of something that your mother buys at the grocery store, okay? And I want you to tell me, okay? And this is the way the song goes. I'll start it off, all right? Here we go. Sit down. Here we go. This is about my mother going to the grocery store.
Yeah.
Mi madre fue a la tienda, mi madre fue a la tienda, la leche a comprar y pronto volverá. You know what leche is?
Yeah,
what's
milk.
Leche? Hey,
milk.
Leche, right. My mother bought some milk. Let's see, what else does your mother buy at the grocery store?
Bacon.
Bacon, okay.
Cereal.
Mi madre fue a la tienda, mi madre fue a la tienda, el bacon a comprar no tarda en llegar. Hey, very good. El bacon a comprar no tarda en llegar. A ver, ¿qué más? How about fruta?
Yeah, fruit.
Fruta, ¿verdad?
Fruit.
Fruit is fruta. Here we go. about my sister going to the store this time, okay?
Yeah.
Mi hermana fue a la tienda, mi hermana fue a la tienda, la fruta a comprar, no tarda en llegar, la fruta a comprar, no tarda en llegar. ¿Qué más? Hey, Sean, what does your mother buy at the grocery store?
Cookies.
Cookies? All right, here we go. Mi madre fue a la tienda, mi madre fue a la tienda, los cookies a comprar, no tarda en llegar, los cookies a comprar, no tarda en llegar. Hey, ¿qué más? ¿Qué
Bologna.
Más? Bologna?
Yeah.
Oh, aquí vamos. ¿Wanna sing, Willie?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Mi madre fue a la tienda, mi madre fue a la tienda, bologna a comprar, no tarda en llegar, la bologna a comprar, no tarda en llegar. How about my abuelito? He went to the store and he was going to buy some candies, and we don't know what happened to him. He left. The candies.
Okay.
Mi abuelito fue a la tienda, mi abuelito fue a la tienda, los dulces a comprar, no sabemos dónde está. Mi abuelito fue a la tienda, mi abuelito fue a la tienda, los dulces a comprar, no sé dónde está mi abuelito. ¡Eh! ¡Qué bien! Aquí vamos otra vez. ¿Qué más? What?
Bread, chicken, bread.
Chicken.
Bread.
Gallina, la gallina. Aquí vamos. How about my tío? My uncle is going to go to the store this time, okay? Here we go, my tío. Mi tío fue a la tienda, mi tío fue a la tienda, la gallina a comprar, y pronto volverá, la gallina a comprar, y pronto volverá. ¡Qué bien! Hey, how about if we all go to the store and see if we can find some manzanas?
Yeah.
You know what manzanas are?
Apples.
Apples, right. Okay, let's all sing it together, okay? Nos vamos a la tienda, nos vamos a la tienda, manzanas a comprar. No sé cuándo volveremos, manzanas a comprar, y no sé cuándo volveremos. Vámonos a la tienda, comprad manzanas, vámonos. Nos vamos a la tienda, nos vamos a la tienda, manzanas a comprar, y pronto volveremos, manzanas a comprar, y pronto volveremos.
¿Qué es eso?
Una línea.
Una línea que va para arriba y para abajo.
No es más que eso.
Ahora es una línea con un triángulo.
Una bandera.
Y ahora es una línea con dos triángulos.
Ya sé, es un paraguas.
No.
Me equivoqué.
¿Tres triángulos?
¿Qué es eso?
Ahora son cuatro triángulos.
¡Es una cometa! ¿De veras? ¿Es lo que es?
¡Miren, miren lo que le está pasando!
¿Se cayó?
¡Y se le cayó un pedazo! ¿Qué es esto?
¡Ya sé!
¡Es un pescado!
Aunque eso es lo que era.
What's that?
It's just a line.
Just a line going up and down.
No, it's more than that.
Now it's a line with a triangle.
A flag.
And now it's a line with two triangles.
I know, it's an umbrella. I was wrong.
Three triangles?
What is that?
Now it has four triangles.
It's a kite.
That's what it is, all right.
Yes, it's a kite.
Uh-oh, something's happening to it.
It fell over.
And a piece fell out.
What is this?
I see.
It's a fish. So that's what it was.
Hey, everybody. This is your old pal Grover. Yeah, are we going to have so much fun today? Because today, I'm going to tell you about this letter. And this letter is the letter G. Oh, what a cute little letter this is. Tickle, tickle, tickle. Huh. Now, a whole bunch of good words start with the letter G. Now, for instance, a good word is, Grover. Yeah, Grover, that's me. And that starts with the Yeah, Grover starts with the letter G. See, there's a G right there. Now, another word that starts with the letter G is the word good. Yeah, see? Yeah, there's the G there, see? See, G is the beginning of the word good. Oh, that's a fun word, too. Now, here's a really important word. You listening? Okay, here we go. The word is grow. Yeah, see, there's a G. Now, do... Wow. The word grow starts with the letter G. Right. Okay, there.
Now, I tell you why grow is so very, very important. It is important because that is what is happening to you. Yes, or believe it or not, that is true. You are growing, and I am growing, and everybody else is growing. Little bunny rabbits are growing, and all the little butterflies, when they fly in the air, they are growing too. And all the little duckies and the little horses, they're all growing, and the pigs are growing. Yeah, and all the little animals like the gopher is growing, and squirrels, and little caterpillars, and this G. This G is growing? I know not a G word. Goodbye.
Hi. Today's letter is the letter G. You see it there? You can have lots of fun with the letter G because it starts some very good words like games, gifts, grandmas, and guitars. They all start with G. Or what about if you're hungry? There's grapefruit, griddle cakes, gravy, grapes, and gumdrops. Lots of people have jobs that start with G. Well, like garbage men, gardeners, gas men, and go-go dancers. And there's lots and lots of animals, like gorillas, goldfish, geese, gophers, guinea pigs, and goats. It's a great letter, the letter G. I like it.
I just heard that somebody in the neighborhood has a terrible cold, Bert.
Oh, well, what do you know? Mm-hmm. Who'd they say it was, old Ernie Pal?
Well, I don't know who it is, Bert. But I want to find out real quick so I can see if there's anything I can do to help. You know?
Yeah.
I got my handy How to Tell If Somebody Is Sick book. And I'm going to find out who it is that's sick. See?
Listen, Ernie, I can tell you exactly who it is.
Just a second, Bert. Let's see, here it is. It says right here, it says, people who are sick usually get into bed, even if it's in the middle of the day.
Yeah, Ernie, will you straighten out my blanket, please?
Oh, I can't do that right now, Bert. I gotta run and look out the window and see if I can tell who's in bed.
Ernie, you don't have to look out there for that. I can tell you exactly who is sick. Oh, never mind.
Everybody we know seems to be outside today. I don't see anybody missing who might be home and in bed. Gee, I better check that book again.
Oh, brother.
It says here. Okay, the book says that people who are sick often have a high fever.
Hey, Ernie. Ernie, yes? will you feel my forehead, please?
Yes, Bert.
Yeah. Am I hot? Does it feel hot?
Oh, yeah, it's very hot, Bert.
Yeah, I feel hot.
Okay, let's see. It says here that people who have colds...
Ernie,
usually,
can I have some juice, please, there?
Just a second. People who have colds usually drink lots and lots of juice. That's what it says here. People
Ernie,
who have lots of colds...
Ernie, give me some juice, please.
Bert.
What?
Bert, what's the matter with you anyway?
What's the matter with me?
Bert, you've been acting strange all day, Bert. What is it?
Ernie, I'm sick. Look at me. I'm in bed. I have a fever. I'm drinking juice. I'm sneezing and coughing. I'm sick, Ernie. Can't you tell that?
Bert, you're sick.
Yeah.
You're sick, Bert.
Yes, I'm sick, Bert. I'm
then
sick,
you
Bert.
Caught it. You must know who it is that's sick, Bert. Who is it, Bert? Who is it? Who is it so I can go help him, Bert? Bert, who is it, Bert? What, who has that cold, Bert? Why don't you tell me, Bert? Huh? Bert?
E. E. L. Eel.
Jump, 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 jump. Jump, 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 jump. Jump, 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 jump.
E.
One orangutan.
Two rhinos.
Three elephants.
Four prairie dogs.
Five penguins.
This is a letter G. G is a very useful letter. It's the first letter in the word. As I was saying, G is the first letter in the word. Now then, the letter G is the first letter in the word. The word giggle.
Oh, I'm so sad.
Hey, you. Hey, fuzzy face. Why are you crying and looking up in the sky?
Cookie.
You want a cookie?
I lost my cookie. I dropped my cookie.
Yeah, but you're looking up in the sky. You mean to tell me that you dropped your cookie and you're looking up in the sky for it?
That's right.
Don't you know the difference between up and down?
Oh, sure.
I don't think you do.
No?
But I know something that might help you.
What?
I know a song all about up and down.
You do?
Yes, I do.
Well, so do I.
You do?
Uh-huh.
Well, then what are we waiting for? Let's have some music.
Music!
I look up and see a birdie flying high and free.
Well, I look down and then the sidewalk is what I see.
I look up and see the sky.
I look down and see the ground. I look at you and sing a song about up and down. Yeah, I look down and I see bugs and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah,
know?
I look up and I see a tree.
Hey, I see some ants down there.
Oh, look up there, I see clouds.
Jeez.
Yeah, you know what else I see? Oh, I look up and see an airplane flying. Yes, I do.
Well, I look down and see my foot and then I see my shoe.
I look up and see the sky.
I look down and see the ground. I look at you and sing a song about up and down.
I can't see my cookie.
Well, you're looking in the wrong direction.
Do I look at you? You want my cookie?
No, I don't have
cookies.
No, I don't have a cookie.
Oh, no?
No.
Well, you know what? Oh, I look up and see the ceiling, and there's one thing more.
Well, I look down and see the rug, and then I see the floor.
I looked up and see the sky.
I look down and see the ground. I look at you and sing a song about up and down. Oh, up, up and down, and down,
up and down,
and down.
You do know the difference between up and down.
Oh, sure I do.
And you sing nice, too.
Oh, thank you.
I've only got one question.
What?
If you dropped your cookie, why were you looking up in the sky to find it?
Oh, because I dropped my cookie and a birdie picked it up and flew away with it up in the sky. Oh, there he is. Birdie, come back, Birdie. Oh, drop the cookie at least. Birdie, don't go away with my cookie. Oh, no, give me a break, Birdie. My cookie.
G. Gorilla. Gorilla. G.
Up.
Begins with the letter G.
Uh-oh. This is the letter G. G has a ga sound, as in gopher or gorilla. I wanted to show you something that begins with the letter G, but I couldn't find a single thing. Wait! There is something. Right here. Grass.
Yes, sir, boys. This here's Drake Cookie Thief.
Yeah, well, it's a good thing we put up this wanted poster so that anybody that sees the thief will be able to recognize him.
Yeah.
That's what I think.
Yeah, good thing.
Yep. Hey, fellers, that chap standing over there next to the piano looks very much like the great cookie thief.
Huh?
What?
Great cookie thief?
Kidding.
Oh, yeah? My goodness. Look at that, Sam.
Oh, it could be possibly him. But how would we know whether it's him or not, huh?
Listen here, boys. We're going to have to go over there and check this dude out to see if he's the great cookie thief or not.
Yeah, well,
you go on over there and check
me?
Him out.
Me? But how do I do that?
Well, just go on over there and look at that wanted poster and then look at him and see if they're the same.
Yeah, but how will I know if they're the same? I'm really scared.
Well, just check out one thing at a time.
One thing at a time?
Yeah, check out his eyes.
His eyes.
Hi.
Let's see. The great cookie thief has big, round, white, googly eyes, and this chap here has big, round, white, googly eyes. It's him. It's him. I know it's him. The great cookie thief has round, white, googly eyes, and that chap there has round, white, googly eyes, too. It's him.
Well,
I tell you, it's him.
That ain't enough evidence for me. You go on back over there and check out his fur.
Check out his fur?
Good thinking, Sam.
Well, see, the great cookie thief has blue shaggy fur, and this feller here has blue shaggy fur, too. It's him, it's him. I tell you, it's him. They both have the same eyes, and they have the same fur. I tell you, that's him. That's the great cookie thief. That's him.
Now, that still ain't enough. You better go on back over there and check out his hat.
His hat? Yeah, let's see. The great cookie thief has a big black cowboy hat, and this chap here has a big black cowboy hat, too. It's him! It's him! I tell you, it's him! They have the same eyes, they have the same fur, and they have the same big black cowboy hat. It's him! That's the big cookie thief!
Well, boys, that's good enough for me.
Yeah?
Come on.
What you gonna do?
I'm going over there and check this hombre out.
Oh, yeah?
Listen here, partner.
Hi, partner.
We think that you're the great cookie thief.
Me?
That's right.
Yeah.
We think you're the feller been stealing cookies from all the bakeries in these here parts.
Yeah.
No, not same person. No. Not,
oh, yeah?
No.
Well, just look up at that wanted poster there. See there?
Look,
that's
nice.
A picture of the great cookie thief. He's got big bobbly eyes and blue shaggy fur and a big western hat. Looks just exactly like you.
Yeah, you're right, but not have same mustache.
Mustache?
Yeah.
You ain't got no mustache.
Look over there.
What's that?
Look over there.
What?
Oh, let me go.
What?
Look
over
there.
Look going down the street.
What?
I don't see nothing. Hey, maybe the stagecoach come in.
Uh-huh.
I don't know. You see anything out there, Slick? Never mind
no.
That anyway. Look here, what was you saying about a mustache? You don't have no mustache.
No, but he does.
Look at there.
Yeah.
Say, partner, I'm mighty sorry to have confused you with the great cookie thief. Hope you'll excuse me.
Oh, sure. No hard feelings.
Look at that! It's the great cookie thief!
Oh,
get him!
Bye-bye.
Get him! Get the great cookie thief! Come back here, you thief!
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters E and G, and by the number 9. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.